Okay, welcome to this review of these Optolong LRGB filters. When I initially got my filter wheel, I got some basic filters just to do some just to see if the filter wheel worked and how it worked. But I wanted to improve the pictures I was taking, so I upgraded to these Optolong filters. These are more kind of medium range filters. And they're useful for astrophotography, but they can also be used for some visual observing tasks, such as picking out the details of the planets and that kind of thing. So let's open it up and see what we get inside. So they come in a hard plastic box. Now the first thing to realize about these filters is that they're not actually stackable, as you can see. So they've only got a thread on one end. And this is because they've been designed really to be put into filter wheels. So you won't be able to stack up multiple filters on top of them. They use 2mm thick glass and they're relatively parafocaled, with only small adjustments required when focusing between different filters. They're suitable for both deep sky and planetary photography, which is quite useful. So you don't have to keep on reloading your filter wheel. They also have 95% light transmission, which is quite good. Obviously, you can go better, but that also comes with a heftier price tag. And they have built-in infrared blocking and light pollution blocking of sodium light, I believe, which is very useful. This will knock you back around about £150 at the moment, but they do seem to be very good quality filters. But the best way to tell how good these filters are is actually to take some photos and then have a look at them, which is what we're going to do now. So here comes the classic test in astrophotography, taking a picture of Orion's nebula. And I'm actually pretty pleased with this image. You can see that there's a faint blue down the bottom corner of the screen, a nice kind of strong band of pinkish nebulosity there, and a nice overall spread of the red coloured nebulosity with a nice kind of border around it. You've got to bear in mind that I haven't done that many LRGB shots using my mono camera, and I am actually still practicing on how to do it. However, I think the Optolong filters have definitely improved what I was able to do. I was using a cheaper set of filters before, just to test out my filter wheel, and the results are nowhere near as good as this. I also found that there was very little refocusing required when actually going between the filters, which is quite good. So it's actually definitely quite close to being parafocal. Well, if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. If you like the video, then do please leave a like. And if you'd like to see more astronomy videos, then please subscribe. Goodbye and clear skies.